Real quick, rate my outfit 1 through 10. If it's higher than 5, smash that like button. If it's lower than 5, it's alright. I still appreciate you, so like this video if you appreciate me. My bad, I just had to look drippy today for you guys because I've been getting flamed on my outfits recently. Anyways, back to the video. There was once a young boy by the name of Trouble. Someone so talented and hardworking who sadly eventually lost his way. The pain, the bullying, and hatred was enough to bring him to his lowest point. Hey man, you got any spare change? Not for you, bum. I can buy you. Go get a job or keep digging in trash cans, weirdo. You're pathetic, you fucking bot.
I hate my life. I'm never gonna be anybody. I lost everything, became a bum, and forever will be one. There's no hope anymore.
Hey there, I saw what that guy did to you. I'm just here to tell you that I believe in you. Just by looking at you, I know deep down you are someone special.
Do you believe in me? Thank you. I started to lose sight of everything, but you were the sign I needed to see.
Now it's time to focus and become who I always wanted. Someone who believed in him when he couldn't believe in himself. Helped him realize his love for basketball, who he can become. So he rose to his feet and decided that very second to change his life around. Forget about the past and focus on shaping your future. No turning back, putting everything into this. Blood, sweat, and tears, no more weakness. He has become the strongest, the most determined, and most of all, the greatest shooter of all time!
What's up guys, it's your boy Trouble here, and look at this, man, look what I'm doing! Who do you know on Next Gen that shoots these shots with confidence? Oh.
Fade.
Let's go, man! Y'all thought I was done! I'm kidding, I'm doing this shit, man! I do this shit!
Game on the line, too, I don't give a fuck, man. Here's my shooting percentage, just so you know that I'm not 50 with these. But yeah, this is honestly ridiculous, the shots you can make with Spot Up Takeover. You've seen me make 60%, 80%, and even multiple 100% greens. A lot of people complaining about fading and how it's gonna be patched. Well, take in, for everyone that truly fades in this game, they run both shot creating takeovers. Now you only need Spot Up Takeover to green contested standing threes. So tell me, are you ready to master the art of contested standing greens? Knowing that fading is getting patched very soon? If you are, welcome to my top 5 shooting tips on NBA 2K Next Gen for elite level shooters. Tip number 1, blinders. The blinders badge in this game is absolutely bonkers at the Hall of Fame level. What it does is practically erase the contest on your shot when a defender is on your hip or in your peripheral vision. Looking here, this badge, when used correctly, can be the most OP badge in the game, especially when it's mixed with Spot Up Takeover. Oh my god. A lot of people complain about this badge. Even though I somewhat agree, I feel like it should be nerfed, just not taken out completely. Mastering the blinders shot will definitely take your shooting to the next level. Tip number 2 is having a jump shot that has an easy cue to green. I talked about this in a previous video, but I'll explain it again. Some people struggle with consistently greening because they use a jump shot that is either too quick for the comfort or that doesn't have a good cue for the green window. For example, the jump shot I use, which you can check out on my channel, has a very easy cue to green since you release the X button just before the ball reaches its maximum height. Also, for the contested shots, this exact jump shot is the best one in the game for it because of how high the cue is. Some people believe it to be true and some don't, but realistically, it makes sense and I've clearly shown proof with the amount of contested greens I've shown you. Look at the advantage you have over the defender, and it looks very fluid and easy to time. However, it is not the fastest shot. For a faster jump shot with a little bit of a harder cue, I suggest using base 98 or base Dwayne Wade with any release combination. It's a great jump shot, however, it doesn't have that high cue to release the ball, so in my opinion, it will shoot less contested greens, but yeah, always be comfortable with your jump shot. Tip number 3, have at least 15 shooting badges. With 15 of them, you will be able to unlock all the necessary badges like deep threes, hot zone hunter, blinders, hot shot, and in cases where you need to spot up, catch and shoot. And obviously, make sure you get your 3-point hot zones. Now, if you have 18 shooting badges like me, which I find is a sweet spot, I'd prioritize hot zone hunter Hall of Fame, then go to blinders Hall of Fame, then hot shot Hall of Fame. After the nerf to takeover, hot shot still remains important. important, so I'd still keep it at the Hall of Fame level. Tip number four is slower fades. A lot of people fade. By a lot, I mean everyone on next gen. And even though it's probably getting patched soon, this certain trick might not. Many of you have learned to fade like this, use the normal fade, holding turbo, sprinting to the corner, and fade to the left or right. You see, that is getting patched for sure because that is absolutely OP and takes almost no skill. However, learning to let go of turbo just as you are about to fade will give you a slower fade animation. It is more realistic, less toxic, and most likely won't get nerfed since Mike Wang clearly stated the difference between each of those fades. I can't find the tweet, but he said it should be easier to make those slower fades than it is the faster ones. Plus, the slower one combines really well with the blinders badge. So yeah, start practicing it. Okay, now tip number five is getting familiar with all types of shots. I'll name two important ones right here. First off is the catch and shoot three. Now I know many guards that don't like to shoot off the catch for multiple reasons. Could be they don't have catch and shoot on and they don't feel comfortable with that shot, but most likely it's because they are not used to that type of shot. It also tends to be quicker release than off the dribble three pointer. I know many guards that pass up catch and shoot shots and dribbles for a bit and then shoots the three pointer. It's just because, I don't know, maybe they were never a spot up. They were never used to that type of shot. So yeah, me being a spot up, I'm fine with catch and shoot, but it also could be vice versa, where certain people can't shoot off the dribble. Not me though, because I'm a demon, so yeah, you know my body. But yeah, next is the gather jump shot. This certain gathered release has been in the game for a very long time, and it happens only when you don't wait to set your feet. As you can see, you don't jump on the shot, and you shoot almost sideways. You're also less likely to make this shot percentage-wise. It's a really weird shot, but I don't mind shooting it because I've adapted to it. Just use the same principles as a regular jump shot for this. Look at the cue to release the ball and shoot. Nothing else to it really. I mean, getting familiar with this type of release will prepare you for when the situation happens. That was it guys, that was my top 5 tips for shooting on next gen, as well as showing you a little montage of contested greens and whatnot, and the intro as well. Smash the like if you guys liked all of those things. More videos to come. Make sure to follow me on Twitter and Twitch, as I stream 4 to 5 times a week on there, and I'm very active on Twitter. On the road to 200 subs on here, so let's keep the grind going. I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace. Yo, step up. Step up right now. Step up right now. Get off my court, bitch! Get off my court! Get off my court! Let's go!